Hi everyone, today we're looking at the Anyone Router, a device that protects your online privacy while earning you tokens. I will cover what it does, how much you might earn, and what to know before getting one. Alright, let's dive in. This is the Anyone Router, or Hardware Relay, a plug-and-play device that boosts my internet privacy. It's part of the Anyone Protocol, a decentralized network to keep your online activity anonymous without relying on centralized VPN servers like NordVPN uses. The Anyone Router routes your data through a global network of user-operated nodes, just like this one, encrypting it multiple times to obscure its origin and destination. So this eliminates the need to trust a single provider, as no central entity controls the network or logs your online activity. To basically use this device, we plug it in, connect it to our Wi-Fi, and it creates a secure hotspot for our devices, routing traffic through this global network of relays. Plus, by also contributing bandwidth to the Anyone protocol, we can earn the Anyone token as a reward. So it's perfect for anyone wanting to secure their browsing, a great VPN, and earn a bit with it as well. So running an Anyone router have lots of advantages, but there's also a catch. You need to have a public-facing IP address to be able to set it up. I ran into trouble because my internet service provider, ISP, uses something called CGNAT, CGNAT, which makes me not able to run it. And so I want to help you avoid the same issue before you think of getting one. Here's how to check if you're good to go before buying the Anyone router, plus some tips if you're stuck behind this CGNAT. But first, why does this matter? Well, the Anyone router acts as a relay, routing private traffic for users, so it needs a public IP to receive incoming connections. If your internet service provider uses carrier-grade NAT, so CGNAT, it shares one's public IP among multiple customers, blocking those connections and making Anyone relays impossible to use without workarounds. So here's how you can find if your internet is behind CGNAT. First, you want to find your public IP here. Then you want to log into your router's admin panel and check the WAN IP under status or network. Then we can compare the two IP addresses. If they differ and your WAN IP is in between this range, then you are behind CGNAT. And so if you're behind CGNAT, you can do one of the following things to resolve it. You can contact your ISP, ask for a public IP, which could become dynamic or static. Some ISPs provide this for free and others charge for a static IP, and some don't offer it at all, like in my case, sadly. For Starlink users, the standard Starlink plans use CGNAT, so relays won't work without upgrading to a priority plan for a public IP. And here are also some workarounds. If you can't get a public IP, you could try getting a VPN with a dedicated IP and port forwarding to bypass the CGNAT. Advanced users could also perhaps use cloud tunneling services, but both of these workarounds add costs and setup time, but they might allow you to run a relay. If your public IP address and your WAN IP match, then you're good to go. Just port forward the required ports. You can check here in the Anyone's setup guide, which I will link to below. I thought I would mention a little bit about Anyone Protocol's tokenomics, how the allocation of their tokens work. Anyone Protocol clearly states that their tokenomics is a living document that will be updated as the network grows and evolves. So it seems they want their tokenomics to be dynamic and can change if they would want, which is not that common. I don't know. What we do know is that the total fixed supply is 100 million Anyone tokens, with 10% being the base amount allocated to relays as rewards, handed out over time in this manner explained here. We can also here see some other small parts of the supply being allocated to various use cases, in total making up 11.75% of the total supply. Alright, let's dive into the current earnings with the Anyone router. First, a quick disclaimer, these reward estimates are based on current data and assumptions. Actual earnings will depend on the network dynamics and your individual router's performance. So relays are rewarded with tokens for contributing bandwidth to the Anyone protocol's decentralized privacy network. They use a proof of uptime system, meaning your earnings depend on how much bandwidth you provide and how long your relay stays active. And that is measured as observed bandwidth, which ramps up over the first 56 days your relay is active. So your token rewards will increase over the first 56 days of it being active. So what can impact the earnings? Well, it comes down to a few key factors: your region, your internet speed, your uptime, and whether you're running an exit relay. The amount of data your router processes, your bandwidth contribution, are however the big drivers. Plus, the more active routers you have, the more you can also earn. But spreading multiple routers out across various locations and ISPs is a better approach to be earning more tokens. Consistency also matters a lot, so keeping your relay up and stable is also very important. Another factor is whether you are using a hardware relay or a software relay. The hardware relay, like the official N1 router, this one here, gets a big advantage because they compete for an exclusive hardware-only reward pool, facing less competition than the general pool that includes both hardware and software relays. Right now, the average reward for N1 router is about 1.5 N1 tokens per day, but this can of course vary depending on your setup and your router's performance. But whenever you're watching this video, you can go to this site right here and scroll down a bit, and you can see the average current token earnings for a router. So what are my thoughts on N1 and the N1 router? Well, as we all know, our online privacy is at risk with the digital environment becoming more and more controlled. And with the upcoming central bank digital currencies, there are a lot more than just privacy at risk. And that's why it's good to see N1 protocol pushing back with decentralized innovation within this privacy sector, because it's clearly needed and a lot of people want it. And thus, I think there will be a great demand for it as well. This is one of these DePIN projects where it is not so difficult to see the use case. And also, I believe with the N1 protocol that it will be able to tie its privacy solutions to other DePIN projects in the future, making all of the data contributions becoming more and more private overall. So N1 protocol could become a very integral, important part of the entire digital space, mostly the DePIN space, but who knows. But overall, I'm quite bullish about N1, mostly because of the utility it could bring. If one is already using a VPN, this could be a great replacement and earn some tokens as well. And who knows, maybe N1 grows a lot and the token value grows as well, but who knows what will happen on that aspect. I will leave below the cheapest place we can get the N1 router if you're interested in it. Alright, let me know what you think about N1 protocol and the router, and I will answer your questions in the comments. Alright, thank you for watching, bye bye.